Moonbase Alpha status report. 2009 days since leaving Earth orbit. Dr. Helena Russell recording. Commander John Koenig is in the North Quadrant investigating a belt of asteroids which gives some hope of colonization.
Signal unknown. Voyager 1, data bank suggests. SOS.
Tony, it's in a position to go into a higher orbit around us.
Magnify.
Our Eagles are just Model Ts compared to that.
It changed course.
Heading?
Directly towards us.
Permission to land. Urgent. We require permission to land.
Identify yourself, please.
My name is Sahala. I come from the galaxy of Crotum. One of my crew is dead, another severely injured. I am left alone to control this ship. Will you permit me to touch down?
No. You do not have permission to touch down.
She says she has injured on board.
We have a plague on board, but isolated. There can be no danger to you. Please, will you help?
My own scan on that ship.
Croton. Our Psychon astronomers did identify controlled sources of photon emission in the third galaxy. The scanner confirms. The ship is photon driven.
What's its armament?
It has no armament.
Helena, will you get a medical team down to the launch area, take care of the injured, wear anti-contamination suits, and check, double check, that there is absolutely no danger to any of us from the plague before you board the ship.
Right.
You have permission to land.
Thank you.
Helena. Take Maya, go meet the landing party, and make sure there's no threat. Lower launch pad to boarding level.
Apart from the skull fracture, she's lost a lot of blood.
But with your help, we can save her. We must. How did it happen? We have a criminal on board, one who nearly destroyed our civilization. My mission was to deliver him to exile on Thessalina, the most distant planet of our Croton system. Well, for a few disastrous moments, he broke loose, and this is the result.
And this criminal is the nature of the plague you carry.
Yes, but we now have him safely in isolation.
She'll go right to our medical center.
What have you done?
What I had to do. We'll be right back.
Not a thing.
There's no sign of any decay, just some form of suspension.
I've never seen anything like it.
How's Yester?
Not good. I'm waiting for the lab report.
We'll have to operate.
Because she's a psychon.
And that gives you the right to shoot her? Because she's a psychon?
Yes, because of what they've done to my people. We were...
I don't care what you were! Now look, if Maya doesn't come out of this, then you are going to remain locked here in detention for the rest of your life.
Please let me tell you.
Now you cannot tell me anything.
Tony, give her a chance.
Alan, she gets nothing.
Oh, come on, Alan, let's go.
I'll be with you in a second.
Okay, but a guard stays outside this door permanently.
Thank you for trying to be kind.
Well, it's not that I'm a better listener than Tony. It's just that Maya means an awful lot to him.
The Croton system is made up of many peoples in many planets, of which my planet Norva was one. For thousands of decons, it has been cultivated into a peace-loving federation.
Well, the planet Psychon, is that a member?
We didn't know of its existence until the arrival of one named Dorzak. He came in a spaceship with other Psychons, begging for refuge, stating that his own planet was about to be destroyed.
Yes, Maya knew that some of her people left Psychon before it blew up, but she never knew if they ever made it to another star system.
Technologically, they were very advanced, and we welcomed them on Norva. But in time, we realized the Psychons were a virus that would destroy our society.
Now, wait a minute. You see, you've got something out of balance. Maya is no virus.
You don't know Psychons like we do. Their power is insidious. Dorzak incited to violence people who had been at peace for thousands of years.
But you said Dorzak's the prisoner on the ship.
Yes, we developed a weapon to defeat him, and the psychology to use it.
Well, the weapon you used against Maya?
The Staser. Please help me.
If Maya doesn't recover...
Crotons don't kill. That was our weakness against Dorzak. I can bring her back.
Well, do that, and you get Tony on your side.
Staser. Can you convince him to trust me?
Let him prove you wrong, Tony.
I've got a pulse. How do you feel?
I feel fine.
Why? Why did you do that?
Because you are a Psychon. I have had experience with Psychon.
Get her away from me.
Oh, it's okay, Maya. Now, wait a while.
Get her away from me!
Take it easy, Maya.
All right, I want her back in detention. With a guard outside her door at all times. Maya, listen to me. One of the spaceships that escaped from Psychon before it blew up, it made it to the Croton system.
That's wonderful! Isn't it?
They caused grief when they got there. It seems one of your people, Dorzak.
Dorzak?
Yeah, but listen. According to Sahala, he turned on them. He tried to take over.
Oh, no, she's lying.
Well, she says that he incited an insurrection on her planet, Norva.
Oh, she's lying, I tell you.
Dorzak was a philosopher, a poet. He was a man of peace. He wouldn't change.
Well, the claim is that he caused great suffering there.
That can't be.
Well, she's taking him to exile.
He's alive.
He's a prisoner on Zahala's ship.
Here.
Tony, I want to see him. Please take me to him.
Am I so much a leper I must eat alone?
I wouldn't think of it.
You seem somehow different from the others.
Different? No. We all come from the same planet, Earth. Oh, unless you mean my accent. Yeah, I guess I am a little different. On Earth, I come from a country called Australia.
Australia? Is that very important?
Yeah, it is to me.
Our origins are different, but you are very easy to be with, and you are kind.
Well, that's because you're easy to be with.
There's only one way to repay you for your kindness, by continually warning you of the danger you are in. Your Psychon Maya will do her best to free Dorzak.
Maya will do nothing she is not permitted to do.
Their loyalty to each other transcends all other relationships.
You don't know Maya.
I don't know Maya, but I do know Dorzak. Even in stasis, he's dangerous. One of my crew is dead, and another near dead. They were both specially selected for their ability to resist his psychological attack. But even so, he got through their defenses.
How?
Well, the trouble began when we were halfway to Thessalina, the planet to which Dorzak was exiled. The journey to Thessalina is the longest we make, and apart from the presence of Dorzak, the crew had to face the psychological stress of this very long flight. She was on watch when things began to go wrong, and she was unfortunately not as strong as Yessa and myself against the fatal influence of Dorzak, even as he lay in stasis.
We are approaching a rogue asteroid. It is the former moon from planet Earth. Its trajectory is random and it is inhabited by 200 humans. Their culture is primitive, being bound by the laws of the ancient continent. They represent no danger to the mission. Course adjustments have been made to avoid collision. Communications complete.
Thank you, computer.
I am reporting a fault in the long-range communicator. The fault lies
in... Quiet!
arrived in Thessalina?
How could I ever allow them to submit you to that indignity?
But where are we?
Approaching an asteroid. There are 300 people there. Backward, but potentially useful.
What do you have in mind?
We could take over the ship and use their base for return to Norva.
What about the others?
I thought that you could eliminate them, after the Psycon fashion.
Why are you doing this for me?
Oh, Dorzak.
Claire, Claire. My wonderful Claire.
Oh, no. What have I been doing?
He is evil, Claire. Evil.
I know. I know.
Come. Come. How did it happen?
I don't know.
I'll get you something to drink.
When I woke to take over the watch in the normal way, Yester had nearly bled to death.
What happened to Claire?
Well, I released her from stasis. Then she confessed what I've just told you. The guilt was too much for her to bear. She threw herself out into space. And that's when I changed course to ask for your help.
Mr. Verdeschi would like you to bring Sahala to him.
Where is he?
At the docking port, waiting to enter the Croton ship.
Is the Psycon Maya with him?
Yes.
You see, it begins.
Tony, why do we have to wait for her permission?
It's protocol, Maya. We don't go aboard a visiting spaceship unless we have permission from its commander.
Even if she's obviously trying to deceive us?
We're not sure of that, Maya.
We would like permission to board your ship.
For what purpose?
So that we can talk to Dorza.
You cannot talk to him. He's in stasis.
You can bring him out of stasis just long enough for us to ask him a few questions. You should be anxious to cooperate if you were telling the truth.
She is. Why don't you listen to her?
If I am lying, why is Dorzak a prisoner on my ship? Because Dorzak was in command and you were the one in stasis.
Just like a Psycon. Twist a lie to resemble the truth.
Quit stalling, Sahala. Let us talk to Dorzak. We'll know the truth soon enough. Just you get him out of stasis.
Too dangerous.
Look, there is a witness that can tell us what happened. She's in the medical center, Yester.
She is still unconscious. It's safer to wait till she regains consciousness. We don't know that she ever will.
Sahala, I don't want to board your ship without your permission. But if you don't give it, I will anyway.
And it's on kill. Mr. Verdeschi, will you move from the entry hatch?
All right, get her back to detention. Find Dorzak. Thanks. You had me worried for a while. Thought maybe she'd got to you.
She has got to me.
Impressive place.
Yeah. Crotons are obviously very cultured people.
Just like the lady said.
something?
Yeah, looks more functional than ornamental.
Yeah, I've been through the other alcoves. No trace of anything similar.
What do you think, an electronic bug?
Yeah, it could be. Maybe some kind of charm.
I'll get technical to check it out.
Field.
He doesn't look much of a menace there, does he?
Well, he sleeps easy for somebody who perverts minds.
He doesn't pervert minds. More than likely, the Crotons were so impressed by him that they were drawn to him.
That's possible. His ideas were seen as a threat to the Croton establishment.
If the Crotons were oppressing the people and he was opposing them, of course they'd send him into exile. Then Sahala could be telling the truth, at least about what happened on the ship. Well, a version of the truth, anything to keep us from reviving him.
What if Sahala is telling the whole truth about that man?
And if she is, it would be dangerous to revive him. Tony.
I'm not sure we ought to take that risk.
But he's a wonderful man. I know him. You knew him, Maya. On Saigon, you know nothing of him since he left.
Dr. Russell?
Yes, Ed.
We're ready to operate.
I'm on my way.
Helena. If you can bring Yester back to consciousness, it might help solve a lot of problems.
Tony, I'm not the only Psycon alive.
I know.
I think I can get him out of stasis.
Now, why don't we wait until we hear Yester's story?
I never thought I was ever going to see anyone of my own race again. I must speak to him.
If what Sahala said is true...
Well, even if her accusations are true, he can't harm anyone. He's behind a force field.
Okay. Go ahead. See if you can revive him.
First phase is to relieve the cortical pressure caused by the compound fracture.
Guess we've been successful in stopping the internal hemorrhage.
It may recur. All monitors functioning.
Yeah. What do you make of this?
I don't know. It seems to be some sort of metal alloy.
Just could be a deliberate implant of some kind.
Mm. It'll have to come out. It's involved in the wound. All set then? Run some tests on this, Ed, please.
Tony.
Yes, Anna.
Yes, he'll be out of the anesthetic in a few minutes.
Okay, I'll be right there. Now, Maya, that force field must remain intact.
I understand, Tony.
Let's go, Alan. Get Sahala to medical center. Maya, can you handle it?
Don't worry, Tony. I wouldn't do anything against Alpha.
It is Maya, isn't it? Daughter of Mentor. But how are you here in this Croton ship? I thought you were dead.
I survived the destruction of Sycon. The only survivor. We thought all of you were dead.
I survived the hatred of the Crotons. The only survivor. It's just you and me, Maya. We're the only Sycons alive. The force field. I thought you came to rescue me, Maya. Am I still a prisoner, then?
Not for long. Sahala, the commander of this ship.
Sahala? That evil being. What lies has she told about me?
Her lies won't help her now that Yester's been revived.
Yes. If there is a Croton with integrity, it's Yester. Where is she?
In medical center.
While we wait for the truth to come out, tell me of yourself, Maya, since I saw you last.
She's coming out of it. Yester.
I am Yester.
And Mentor tried to restore the planet by the use of a biological computer.
Thank you, Dr. Russell, for helping my friend.
How is she? She doesn't know where she is. She doesn't know me. A familiar face would be reassuring. Yester. Sahala is here. Yester. Yester.
Take her away!
Did to the Sycons. We should have let them live in peace.
Yes, darling.
Get away! Get away! Get away from me! She killed Claire! But Mentor's brilliant intellect was not sufficient. Sycon blew up. She's dead.
Well, at least we know where we stand.
Dorzak is innocent.
I knew it.
If you succeed in reviving Dorzak.
I already have. Then I have your permission to release him from the force field?
Yes. Take him to more comfortable quarters. Level D.
Your faith sustained us both.
Get her back to detention. She's obviously lying, Alan.
Obviously. Something doesn't hang together here, Tony.
She talked about Dorzak's mind having power over other people. Maybe she's the one with the power. Will you take some advice from an old buddy?
Stay away from her.
Something like that.
Hey, Sam.
Hi.
I want you to run a check on that for me, will you?
I just ran a check on the twin of that for Dr. Russell.
Yeah? Oh, well, how about filling me in?
Sure. Now, this is the one Dr. Russell removed from Yester's head. It's a neuropulsonic jammer.
A deliberate implant?
Well, I didn't say that. Dr. Russell said it.
What was it supposed to jam? You have any ideas?
Now, these are organic psychowaves.
What does that mean?
Well, they're electrical impulses associated with extrasensory perception.
If I was going to give you an order or a message, the impulses from my brain would look like that?
Yes, they would.
And you could jam that message if you had one of these implanted in your head?
Exactly.
Whew. Sam, did our sensors pick up any organic psychowaves like these transmitted today?
Yes, they did.
You must tell me more about the technique of molecular transformation. Have you mastered it?
I have. Of course, with the help of my father.
What about your friends on Alpha? Have you taught them the technique?
Only Psycons have the unique molecular structure that permits the transformation.
Then you must teach me.
You're so brilliant about everything. I enjoy doing something you cannot.
You must teach me the principle.
Maya, will you report to medical center, please?
I'll be right there, Tony. Exercise that famous brain of yours in finding my elfin friends a habitable planet, and I will teach you molecular transformation when I get back.
There it is, just behind the ear, right under the scalp flap. It's a simple operation, but done in minutes.
If only we'd known what that thing was before we removed it from Yester.
Oh, Yester. Poor Yester. She died with those foul accusations on her lips. She must be in misery thinking I might blame her.
No. Wherever she is, she'd know that you wouldn't blame her.
Then you're convinced I'm telling the truth?
Of course.
Maya, look at this. It's a neuropulsonic jammer.
Its purpose is to jam electrical waves, amongst other things.
Yeah, such as hypnosuggestion.
Now, our sensors picked up a hypnosuggestion transmission at 1300 hours and 22. That was the time that you brought Dorzak out of stasis.
And they stopped. Just after Yester's death.
She's accusing Dorzak of transmitting those impulses.
Yes. The Crotons developed the device to jam psycho waves before they enter the brain.
Well, if that's true, then why was Claire affected and Yester?
Claire was in love with Dorzak and removed the one thing that protected her from his power.
I have to take the responsibility for Yester. I removed the device, and Dorzak was able to have her say what he wanted us to hear.
Helena, how can we be sure that she's not tricking us?
Maya, we can't be sure of Dorzak either. Now, if he can control minds from stasis, he could take us over completely.
The only one who he can't control is Sahala.
Yes. Give me your weapon. I'll take him prisoner again.
No, Tony.
Don't worry. I don't intend to do that. Would you escort the lady back to detention? Please.
It's going to be okay this time.
Maya, there is a way we can get to know the truth. If Sahala and Dorzak were left alone together, then all the cards would be on the table.
Personnel. The Croton woman Sahala has broken out of detention and is holding Dr. Russell hostage at gunpoint.
She is presently in Section L, proceeding towards the Croton ship. No one, I repeat, no one is to try to stop her.
If I can help in any way... Well, thank you. If any of your people suffered injury because of me...
All right, Alan, how did it happen?
I don't know.
Well, what the hell is security playing at?
Tell Sir Haller that you will exchange me for Dr. Russell. That is what she wants.
It crossed my mind.
They're on their way to the Croton ship.
I have a demand to make, Mr. Verdeschi.
Yeah, I'll bet. Dorzak for Dr. Russell.
Correct. And should Dorzak make you reluctant, may I remind you that if I choose to ignite the photon drive before I am clear of Alpha, all life here will be extinguished by radiation.
I thought Crotons didn't kill.
It's the language you appear to understand. I expect the Psycon immediately.
Dorzak?
It's absurd we should be at war.
War seems to come naturally to you, Psycons.
This far from Norva, I see things clearer. You Crotons are in far greater danger from yourselves than you are from Psycons.
We're no longer in danger from you.
But your civilization is enfeebled by contentment. We Psycons are steeled by the struggle for survival.
You cannot subvert my mind as you did Yester's.
It may be decades old, but your civilization was based originally on military supremacy. Only when that was achieved could the luxury of culture grow.
On the Stasis couch. This gun is set to kill.
Yes. The couch is very comfortable.
How did you subvert Yester's mind?
You should know that. Sahala would know. Why do you tremble, Sahala?
I am not trembling.
Are you suddenly afraid of me? Sahala would not be afraid of me. Do you know why you are afraid of me? Because you are not Sahala. You are Maya. Betrayed me.
Oh, she must know by now.
Give her another couple of minutes, then we'll go in.
Is there some flaw in the Psycon nature that turns us all into monsters? First my father, and now you.
Philosophy doesn't win space for people to live. It's the struggle for survival that makes monsters of us all.
But the Alphans aren't warped by their struggle.
They are a pathetic example of the lingering process of extinction. Without your Psycon help, they would have died a dozen deaths.
They saved me from our doomed planet.
You are a child, Maya. A child that can be of great service to me.
I refuse.
Only the Crotons are trained to operate their spaceship, so I must have Sahala under my control. To do that, I must have Dr. Russell remove the neuropulsonic jammer. I command you to convey to me the knowledge of molecular transformation.
It's been too long.
Right.
I was wrong.
Are you all right?
Not really. I could hardly believe what I heard. From his own lips, he's not the Dorzak I knew.
I'm gonna go tell Sahara. Hey! Tell her she can have her ship back now. But I want it off Moonbase as soon as possible.
I was afraid. He's safely in stasis now, Maya. There's no need to be afraid anymore.
Hey, I know what would cheer you up. How about a beer? I just made a fresh lot. You know how my beer always cheers you up.
Yes, I'd love some.
Oh, great. Then there is a fabulous French restaurant that I know at the end of Block D, Level 9. Oh la la. Or we could have a nice, relaxing time floating around in outer space. Come on, let's celebrate, sweetheart.
In a while, too. I'd like to stay here and apologize to Sahara.
Apologize? Oh, come on, Maya, you don't have to do that.
Please, Tony. I'll meet you back in command center.
Okay, but I'll be waiting. Come on, Eleanor, let's go.
You go ahead, Tony. Before they leave, I'd like to learn something about stasis.
It's just not my day.
I want you to perform an operation for me, Doctor.
Yes, Dorzak. Then I may go back to my ship.
Maya caught him off guard. He thought he was talking to you. We got the truth.
How can I thank you?
Well, you can start by forgiving us for doubting you.
I felt through it all you were my friend.
I was, and I am.
Helena, I have the report you asked for. Yes, sir.
Helena was just in here.
She's a doctor. That's a medical center. Hmm?
She picked up some surgical instruments and walked out without saying a word. I had some reports she was anxious to see, and she didn't care. Her actions were, well, very unusual.
Oh, there have been a lot of unusual things happening around here lately, Ed. You know, I even suggested Maya have some of my beer just now, and she actually said she'd love some.
Oh, well, that's pretty unusual behavior.
From Maya.
Well, it's a relief to see him safely in stasis again.
Don't feel too comfortable. Mr. Carter, if you will hand your weapon to me. And now, Mr. Carter, if you will walk into the stasis chamber, please. Forgive me for pointing. That's you, Sahara, but until that implant is removed from your head, I cannot reach your mind. Ah, Dr. Russell, would you kindly prepare yourself, Sahara? Dr. Russell has agreed to perform the necessary operation.
She just took the surgical instruments out of that drawer, walked out without a word. She's just never acted that way before. Something bothering her?
I'm not sure. Dr. Russell, your patient is ready. Mr. Vedeshi, if you will hand me your weapon, please. Helena, you all right?
Yes.
Welcome back.
It's all right, Maya. Everything is all right now. What happened?
I'll let you know everything as soon as we get Dorzak back behind this force field.
Nice job of inserting that capsule, Doctor.
Nice job removing it, Doctor.
Where's Alan? The least he could do is spare me a few grateful words for saving his alien friend.
He's with his alien friend right now.
Crotons are conditioned never to be sad at departing, but I am ashamed to say I am sad at this one.
Well, I'm not conditioned. And I'm not ashamed of the way I feel. Knowing I'm going to see you.
How does your species say goodbye?
How do you say goodbye, Alan?
The way you say goodbye is better.
We've got a right to know what's happening.
Well, something is, that's for sure. The command center's off limits, the screens are all blank.
Don't tell me I'm not supposed to be here, right? Well, I am here. And I'm gonna find out what you've got on that screen.
I have to take responsibility.
Responsibility for what? Mutiny?